Hello everyone, my name is Harvey Singh and I'm the CEO of Instancy, where we develop artificial intelligence-based solutions for training and education. I also write about the need for human transformation and change on lifeisrelationship.com. With an academic background in computer science and education, I've spent over 30 years in researching and developing ways in which we can leverage technology to bring about improvement in human learning. I'll be speaking about the massive innovation in artificial intelligence and a parallel need for human transformation. And this is something that we will achieve through self-observation. Now, this conversation is not about instilling fear of technology, but it's rather talking about how we can understand our divisions, which are based on illusions. And by resolving those divisions, we can move forward in life. And these illusions are actually driving some of these destructive uses of technology. So you and I have an important role to play, and we can bring about a change by living harmoniously, peacefully, using technology effectively, and fully developing our human potential. Now, over the last few years, we have seen a tremendous rise of the internet, social media, smartphones, and many such innovative transformations. But the latest innovations in artificial intelligence and genetic engineering represent a remarkable turning point in the technological evolution, and they will redefine the way we live, work, and play. Now, the impact of these technologies on humanity is determined by the state of our collective consciousness and the intentions that arise from it. So think for a moment that AI is a rapidly growing child, currently at a conversational stage, where we can converse with it naturally, like a customer service chatbot or ChatGPT that answers our questions and can also write essays and poems. But as AI matures, it will be able to perform more complex tasks akin to a PhD level assistant, eventually working independently like a super reliable team member. And the next growth in AI is AI innovating autonomously and improving processes without much input. And the next frontier is superintelligence, where AI will surpass human capability in almost every domain. Now, these rapid advancements will impact all industries and will help us, you know, innovate in every domain. And now, these capabilities will actually make us think about the ethical and social implications of these advancements. Now, if you think about the potential benefits to humanity, there are tremendous possibilities. Imagine the doctors will be able to predict the disease conditions and create personalized treatment plans. AI is making this possible in healthcare. Now, AI can potentially save countless lives. In the field of education, AI can be a personalized tutor and can adapt the lesson plans based on the learning styles and make learning available to everyone. In the field of our work, AI will take on repetitive tasks and boring work so that we can take on more creative and challenging tasks. In the case of language barriers, AI will make language possible and communication across the globe. AI will also be a powerful ally in combating climate change by predicting natural disasters and also helping us utilize our resource effectively. AI will transform all industries by accelerating scientific research and will help us innovate in the areas of agriculture, energy, and space exploration. AI can also get into areas which were previously deemed impossible. But now let's wait for a minute. Imagine if you have been handed keys to a powerful sports car, but you have barely mastered riding a bicycle. That's where we are with technology and society today, where our technological progress has been moving at a very rapid pace, but our understanding of ourselves lags behind. We can edit genes, but we are not able to edit our prejudices. Our technological progress has been exponential, but our human psychological growth has not kept pace. Look at some of the trends. We have a rapid rise globally, and depression and loneliness shows us that despite the connectivity, people are feeling isolated. We are seeing challenges and deterioration in the family relationships, where despite technological advancements, people are caught up in various challenges and distractions and not spending quality time and not resolving their conflicts as they arise. At the societal level, we're seeing heightened polarization that is making impossible for us to find common ground and solve our common problems. We're seeing escalation in global crisis and war, and technology is only increasing the suffering. We're seeing, despite technological advancement, the degradation in our environment. So these trends point out a crucial gap that our emotional intelligence and our empathy aren't moving alongside technology. So the transformation that we need is beyond the gadgets and the algorithms. We need a profound change in our hearts and minds. Now, as we see the tremendous advantage of AI and bioengineering, we must use these technologies wisely, because these powerful technologies in the world that hasn't yet figured out how to live peacefully require careful consideration. Because think about it, AI can be used to create new weapons, to spread misinformation rapidly, and to manipulate public opinion at a rapid and mass scale, erode privacy through surveillance, and to accelerate environmental damage if used carelessly. But remember, technology isn't just good and bad by itself. It's our state of mind and how we use it. So let us focus on developing our human skills, awareness, and wisdom to drive the technologies responsibly. This is not about worrying, but it's about proactively working together to shape the future that we all want to live in. Now, before we go further, let's ask ourselves the question that why our technological progress has been so rapid and our psychological understanding of ourselves has been stagnant. We have invested heavily in external and technological progress while we have neglected the most crucial aspect, which is understanding our own minds. At this juncture, we must prioritize inner awareness and focus on understanding the root causes of our psychological struggles. Now, this self-understanding and clarity is not an option. It is actually a necessity in the ever-changing landscape and complexity of life. So think about it. We need human skills like critical thinking that allows us to question the information, including our own assumptions and our own beliefs. We need creativity to be able to think anew, to go beyond our previous thoughts and ideas and solve our problems. We need emotional intelligence to understand ourselves and others. We also need communication skills to be able to express ourselves. And we need adaptability to change with the times and resilience to bounce back from setbacks. We need collaboration and conflict resolution skills to be able to work with people from diverse cultures. And we need empathy, our human skill, to be able to understand and share our feelings. And mental well-being is what is necessary to find our balance in the constant changing realities. Most importantly, the heart of these human skills, we need self-awareness. So self-awareness is the ability to observe ourselves objectively, much like we would our body or external environment. By turning our attention inward, we can see the rise of our thoughts and how they impact our emotions and behaviors. It's like watching our inner mental movie. Our thoughts are based on our day-to-day experiences and the knowledge and memory that gets registered in our brain. These thoughts are necessary tools that we need to navigate our world. It's kind of like artificial intelligence has been trained to work on the data and knowledge. However, these thoughts, memories, and knowledge create distortion in the perception of reality when applied to ourselves psychologically and our relationships, which are dynamic and living. So no thought is actually complete. Our knowledge is limited. In fact, it gives us an impression that it's complete, but it's not. So these limitations create mental frameworks that create misunderstandings and lead to self-destructive behaviors and results in our psychological challenges and contribution to the global conflicts. So thoughts which are meant to help can harm us if taken as absolute truths without questioning. So let us look at some of the examples of how our thoughts lead us astray. At a personal level, we are constantly creating self-images based on specific experiences. For instance, a student who fails a math test generalizes and concludes that they're not smart. Our thoughts tend to travel and project fear. One failure in the business venture and the entrepreneur can start thinking that their next venture is also going to be a disaster. Now, what about constant comparison, which leads to feeling of inadequacy? Now, not only are these thoughts impacting us on the personal level, but they spill over into our relationships. By creating a grudge against someone, it damages our relationships. Labeling a person based on limited interactions creates stereotypes and leads to misunderstandings. Now, take these thoughts at a global level where we share our thoughts. If we fixate on ideologies, that clouds our judgment and makes it impossible to have a constructive dialogue. By clinging to a belief, we can limit our growth and create echo chambers that divide us. Now, these are just a few examples of the limiting thought patterns which actually create self-images and perceptions of others and situations. But we can begin to observe many such limiting thought patterns in ourselves. And this does not require any kind of an academic analysis, but rather a simple observation without judgment. And by recognizing these limiting thought patterns and their implications and the divisions that they create, we can break free from them. And self-awareness is the first step to creating a relationship with ourselves and others authentically and compassionately. Now, as we conclude, let us reflect on the transformative power of understanding our nature of our thoughts. Now, we see that our thoughts are partial. They are fragmentary and they are transient. Now, these thoughts, actually, once we understand their limitations, we can begin to move from limitation to a more holistic realization of our perceptions and our relationships. And we move from being trapped in our memories to being present and fresh in our life. From self-importance, we can move to open-mindedness. And from fragmentary thinking, we can move to a more holistic view of reality. Now, this awareness leads to understanding that everything is interconnected, and we can begin to, you know, realize the importance of harmony over limited thoughts and knowledge. Now, despite all these technological advancements, this inner revolution is crucial. Because remember, artificial intelligence can handle all the data and knowledge much better than we can now. But it is our unique role as humans to live peacefully and compassionately. And this, no technology and computer can replicate. By understanding the power of our empathy and understanding, we can create a world where technology serves humanity, not the other way around. And this is a journey we can start here and now. We envision a world where individuals can live freely and harmoniously with others. And this extends the ripple effects of positive change throughout society. We start this journey with self-awareness, and it extends to a global movement towards peace. And we can recognize and create a path to thriving alongside technology while embracing our humanity. Thank you.